not gonna do all the museums in one day because that is crazy, but I am gonna put all of the museums together on one video so you can kind of get an overview of what they're all like. It's not gonna be super detailed, it's not gonna show every exhibit, but hopefully you can see a little bit of what I'm getting to see here. I'm going to start my day at the Smithsonian Castle, which is the visitor center. So the castle has two main parts. One is all about the history of the Smithsonian Institute, and one is a series of objects from each of the Smithsonian museums. Pronounced really big fish. Because I love all things shiny and sparkly, this is by far my favorite section of this museum. I read the sign like 5 times, and yes, it grew like this. Reynolds Center, which is two Smithsonian museums in one. One is the National Portrait Gallery, and one is the Art Museum. I'm gonna start in the Portrait Gallery, because the guy behind the desk said that's where I should start. This is a courtyard in the middle of the museum building, and it has a covered roof so you can enjoy it in all seasons. So there's a unique water feature here, running water that goes from this side down to that. Now we're gonna go this way and go to the American Art Museum. So it is later in the day and Charlie is done with his conference. He's gonna bring over one of his co-workers, Phil, and they are going to join me as we do the next museum, the Air and Space Museum. So Charlie's here and Phil is here.
Specifically for my super quiz kids. That's a model of the Pioneer and that's the model of a Mariner spacecraft.
I really wish I could bring all the super quiz kids here because you guys would have a heyday looking at all the spacecraft. That thing went to space and came back.
This is a model of the Hubble telescope.
Phil has been wanting the Voyager spacecraft. He found it.
A really nice telescope, crystal.
I want my boys here. Look at this. It's the rovers of Mars.
That's a model of the twin rovers, Spirit and Opportunity. This is Sojourner. And this is Curiosity.
This museum was absolutely amazing. We had about 2 hours and it was nowhere near enough. My battery's dying. I probably have way more footage than I'm gonna use. Every single room, every single exhibit made my jaw drop. This place is amazing.
The Smithsonian National Postal Museum.
Amazing. I was like, postal museum, stamps and envelopes, but it's amazing. The postal museum was absolutely amazing. Very hands-on, very kid-friendly, not overly big, but new surprises around every corner. I highly recommend the Postal Museum. I'm in the Museum of American History. This is a night, so Charlie and his coworker Phil are gonna be joining me, and I'm super excited.
Bought a new.
I had one that was about 6 years later than this.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so I can't take you into that exhibit, but it was amazing. They have the flag that flew over Fort McHenry that inspired Francis Scott Key to write the words to the Star Spangled Banner. Was amazing. Can you tell we're in a building for modern art? We are in for a wild ride. Hirshhorn also has an outdoor sculpture garden. A food court that has food that is inspired by the foods of different Native American groups. Prickly pear agua fresca and some fry bread with cheese, and that is still warm and I can't wait to taste it. That is very delicate and refreshing. There's actually like cheese inside of the bread. That's delicious. Thank you. So apparently the Renwick Museum is normally nothing like what I just showed you. It normally has artifacts from throughout history. So it's chunkier pieces, not wall art, but it's American art throughout history. And it just happened that I was here during a brief period of time, about 6 months worth, where they are having the installation art. This museum looks tiny from the outside. It's like the size of a gazebo. But what you do is it's all underground, and it's actually connected to other museums through underground tunnels. So it's pretty confusing to figure out where to go. Like right now, just came into a dead end. So we're gonna go this way. Another dead end. Okay, confirmed with a few people, there's nothing in the Ripley. So now we are headed to the Sackler Museum. This is nearly as confusing as the other museum, but I'm gonna continue going upstairs. Feels a little bit like I'm in an episode of Big Bang Theory where I just keep walking around in circles upstairs. There is a sign that keeps saying to exhibit up. So I don't know how many levels up, but we're gonna keep going. I made it all the way out to the Acostia Community Museum. Can't take the metro here unless you're willing to transfer onto a bus. I made it, so let's go in and see what this is about. About to head to the zoo. So this zoo, like all the other Smithsonians, is free, and it felt really weird to just like walk in and not buy a ticket and not hand someone a ticket. There aren't even turnstiles. There's just a big gate and you walk through the gate from the street. My favorite animals are sea otters and sea turtles, and I think that I'm gonna see some otters. I want to cuddle them. Otters are so great.
Don't do it. Right?
This zoo has two otter places.
This is my face when I finished all the Smithsonians in DC. It's such an exciting thing. I hope you guys like that video. And I have a video for the monuments of DC and a video just of my time here in DC. So check those out too. So I am back in my hotel room after a great week in DC, visiting all of the Smithsonian museums, gardens, and the zoo in DC. It's time for thoughts for next time. Next time, I would love to be able to do this trip with my boys and maybe a time when Charlie doesn't have to work during the day so we can visit these museums together as a family. I also would spend a lot more time in the must-see museums, and if that meant that we didn't have enough time to hit all the museums, I would definitely prioritize more time in the museums that I'm more interested in. Have you been to the Smithsonian's? Which one's your favorite? Which exhibit was your favorite? Tell me in the comments. If you've been to DC, you know that there's a lot more to this city than the Smithsonian's, and you can see my other videos. One is just my time here in DC, and the other is all of the monuments and memorials that I went to. So check them out.